Accelerator here.
Special case for this type of linear
equation for so your new
is much superior compared to the commonly prescribed graph. If it is within this one, the FTR region, then you will say that
okay, so in this video, we'll be discussing about Newton's law of cooling. Okay, so we'll be trying to solve our problems, which involves Newton's law of cooling, and we will be tackling the equations as the differential equations. Okay, so the very first thing to do is for us to know what does Newton's law of cooling means. So it is just a law in which the temperature of a certain body it will increase or decrease or will change depending on the temperature of the surrounding. So meaning if there is a change in the temperature of a body at a certain time, so meaning that there is energy release, so there is a change in temperature. So either it is the law does not apply only on the cooling process, also on the heating process. So if the temperature increases, so that is a heating process, so this law also apply. Okay, so we will have the differential equation for this law. Okay, for the cooling process, okay, let's just use metal. So for the cooling process, we have dT over, so d capital T. Okay, so this is the derivative. So this means rate of change. So K T minus T sub S. Okay, so this is now the, so this is for the, this is for the cooling, no? So we just have this one in orange. This is for the cooling process. Okay, so at on this stage, so the temperature of a body decreases. Now for the heating process, okay, so we have dT, so this is equal to K T sub S times T, and this will be the heating process. Okay, of course we need to know what are these variables stands for. So where dT, so d capital T over dT, this is the rate of change. Okay, the rate of change in temperature of a body. Okay, then the capital T, so this is the temperature of the body, and the T sub S, so that is the surrounding temperature of the surrounding. Okay, so the cooling process, so this is the given differential equation for the cooling process. Okay, so it means that the temperature of the body decreases. Okay, and for the heating process, the temperature of the body increases. So we are now trying to get from these differential equations the time it takes for a certain body to cool off or to be at a certain temperature, and vice versa, at what temperature will the body will be after 6 seconds or 600 seconds exposed to the surrounding. So that is what this equation stands for. So if we are going to analyze the equation, no, we are going to analyze the equation. So this is just basic variable separable equations. Okay, just very basic variable separable equations. If we are going to get the general solution for this one. Okay, so let's just try to get the general solution for this one. So for example, for the cooling process, so we just need to copy this one so that we will not be writing it again on the next slide. Okay, so just copy. Okay, so if we're going to analyze this one, we're going to solve this one, we need to get the general solution. So we will just transpose this one to this part of this equation. So that will be dt over k t sub s is equal to dt. So integrating both sides, so you will end up with ln k, maybe we should put our k here, but nonetheless we could have this one as just put our k on the other side of the equation. Okay, so that we will have a much more simpler solution. Okay, k dt. Okay, so we'll end up with ln t over s at quantity ln t minus t sub s is equal to kt. So we're going to raise both sides by e, so we end up with t minus ts is equal to e kt. So maybe we could have this one as plus c. So depending on how we are going to interpret our, whether it's an ln c or c itself. Okay, so basically this is how we are going to solve this one if we're going to get the general solution for this. Okay, so to apply this one in a situation, so we'll have here the example problem. Okay, so according to Newton's law of cooling, the rate at which a substance cools in air is directly proportional to the difference between the temperature of the substance and that of air. If the temperature of air is 30% and the substance cools from 100 degrees to 70 degrees, so I guess I read that 30 degrees as 30%. So sorry for that. So going back, and the substance cools from 100 degrees to 70 degrees in 15 minutes, how long will it take to cool 100 degrees to 50 degrees? So there is no particular unit for this one, so we would assume that maybe we could assume this one as degrees Celsius. Okay, so first we need to get our given, okay, for the solution. Okay, solution. Okay, so our T, that is the temperature of the body, so the initial temperature of the body, so that is 100 degrees. Okay, 100 degrees, so this is our the initial. Then so this is at t is equal to zero, so initial meaning at the beginning of the experiment or at the beginning of the observation, so the time of that is 0 seconds or the starting point. So another T is equal to 70 degrees at T is equal to 15 minutes. Okay, then the temperature of the surrounding, of course the temperature of the bar of the surrounding will not change, it will be always be equal to the given, which is 30 degrees. So we need to get the time this is the unknown, at which our T is equal to 50 degrees. So some say this is T sub, this is T sub 50, but I will not use that one. Okay, so we just have the initial conditions for that one. So we have now here the given. Now the next thing to do is to know or to is to determine whether this is cooling or heating process. Of course, as you can see, the substance cools from 0 to 70. So there is a decrease in temperature. So therefore, this is cooling process. So we will use the differential equation dT. So d capital T sub dT is equal to K T minus T sub S. Okay? So we'll just copy this one. Okay, just copy this formula here or this equation here. So we'll have a new slide. Okay, so we will simplify this one. Okay, so we have dT. Okay. So we have dT, d sub t. So we just transpose this one to the other side of the equation. So this is variable separable, t sub s k dt. Integrate both sides. We'll end up with ln t minus ts is equal to kt plus c. So we will not get this transform this one into a exponential function. So we need to we can make this one as an exponential function if we want to, but for us to have a much simpler solution, so we'll just have this one in the logarithmic form. Okay, so we need to input now our initial conditions. Okay, maybe I'll use yellow here. At t is equal to 0 seconds, so our t, so the initial temperature will be 100 degrees. So we could substitute this one here. So we have ln 100, our t sub s from the given, that is 30 degrees. So we have minus, minus, okay, 30. So we could omit the unit because they have same unit, so that is that is uniformity itself. Then our k is unknown, our t from in this condition is equal to 0 plus c. So in this equation we can solve for c because this will just be 0. So our c is equal to ln 70. So as a tip, so it is not advisable to have this one in decimal, especially when we are going to input this one in our calculator or to evaluate this one ln 70. So we just leave it that way. Okay, next we need to input the next condition. So from the given, that is 15 minutes, so we could say okay, 15 minutes, maybe we have this one. I hope it will be clear. Okay, so it is not orange. Okay, so at t is equal to 15 minutes, so we just multiply this one to 60 because we are using seconds. That is 15 times 60. Okay, 15 times 60. So if you have a calculator, you could calculate that one. Okay, so 15 times 60, so that will be 900 seconds. Okay, then the temperature for this one is 70 degrees. So we just use the same equation again. So we have, but for this one, this is the, but for at this time, this will be the values that we are going to input. So we have ln, so t is equals to 70 minus 30 for the ts is equal to k times our t is 900 seconds plus our c, which is ln 70. Okay, so from here we could calculate now our k. Okay, so we need to transpose just 70 to this side of the equation. We have ln 70 minus 30, that will be 40. Ln 40 minus ln 70 all over, okay, all over 900 for this one is equal to k. Of course, maybe we could now get our calculator. So we'll just have my calculator on the screen. Okay, let me first open my calculator. Okay, so I will just adjust my video to get the calculator. Okay, so I have the calculator now. Okay, so I hope it will be clear. Maybe I just put here this part. Okay, so we have, that will be ln. So ln, that is a fraction. So ln 40 minus ln 70 all over k, all over 900. Okay. So we will have, so it will be equal to, that will be equal to 6.22 times 10 to the power of negative 4. Okay, so we have now that one. So 6.22. So maybe we could save this one. So let's just store it here on our A. Okay, so we have, so that will be 6.22 times 10 to the power of negative 4. So we have our k is equal to 6.22 times 10 to the power of negative 4. So this is unit less because this is a constant. Now we will just be solving for the required. Okay, so at t is equal to unknown, so our answer will be in seconds, the temperature of the body is 50 degrees. So we'll just input this one. So going back to the equation, lnt minus ts is equal to kt plus c. So ln 100. Okay, so ln 50. So our t is 50. So 50 minus 30. So this is the temperature of the surrounding. Our k is, is it positive or negative? So that is negative. So I forgot, this is negative. Okay, so you could recheck that on your calculator. So it will be negative 6.22 times 10 to the power of negative 4 times our t, which is unknown, plus ln 70. So solving for t, so transpose this one to the side of this equation. So we have ln 50 minus 30, that will be 20, minus ln 70 all over, so our t is, our, this is negative 6.22 times 10 to the power of negative 4. Okay, so we'll call upon now our calculator again. Okay, so we have, we have here, this will be ln, no, log, okay, ln 20 minus ln 70, k Okay. All over negative, all over recall A, because our A is negative, I believe. Okay, so I had a syntax error. Okay, so double parenthesis. Okay, calculate. So okay, negative. So we'll have 2014.75. Okay, so our t time is equal to 214.75 seconds. Okay, so we need to have this one in minutes. So we try to have this one in minutes. So just answer. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So divide. So we have 33.58. Okay, so we have, so we could have our answer also in minutes. Okay, so that will be 33.58. So we have, or equal to 33.58 minutes, and this is now our answer. So that is how we are going to use differential equation in solving problems involving Newton's law of cooling. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something, and if you have questions, you can always comment on the comment section below. And as always, thank you for watching and enjoy learning.